Hey guys, it's Cat33601 here, and today I've got a review of the 1 to 64th scale Green Light International Durastar 4400 tow truck flatbed variation. There are three variations of the International Durastar by Green Light: a beverage hauler, or beverage truck, a flatbed recovery truck, and a tow truck, and there are multiple different color variations of those. This is the black on black flatbed truck. We'll go ahead and start with the functionality. As you can see, the truck rolls forward, the truck rolls back. That's all the functionality. The bed is non-functional, the car lift on the back is non-functional, and yeah, so it rolls forward and back. So we'll go on to the detail. There is a good detailing in the grille, the way it's painted. It's got a good international decal on the front. You've got a nice bumper up front. You've got really nice lights, which are translucent plastic with a little bit of different colors. You can see that there's a little bit of smudged area over here for the light on the fender, or the engine cover or whatever. You can see there's a little bit of grille pattern here in the vent or whatever that would be. I don't know exactly. You've got good chrome rims. The chrome on this model is it's extremely good, and you have, of course, non-steering, once again. Little plastic mud flaps, or not plastic, sorry, cast and die-cast mud flaps, sorry. It's got some anti-slip texture here. Nothing big, just some steps up to the cab. It's got a nice door handle. It's got a really nice chrome mirror. The interior detail is actually pretty good. You've got the chairs, the steering wheel, the console, all that. That's pretty much it on the inside, but that's still nice. You've got some really good detailed little storage boxes. They've got the right shape. They're chromed. They've got little handles on them. And you see there's very little detail on the side here of the body. As we go forward, you see there's a plastic mud flap, another plastic mud flap, a nice rim. Once again, lots of chrome. And you can see that the lift has got a little painted silver dot down there. But yeah, the lift is... has a very nice detail. It's got a lot of detail, a little bit of a diamond plating on it. You can see the lights are nice up back there. Very good decals on the mud flaps. And the bed is, of course, a diamond plate. You can see where it's like the hooks, or whatever those are, hooked to the cable line, which goes to a very nice detailed winch reel. And of course, you've got a nice little light bar, which is a nice addition. It's a good light bar. Once again, the backs, there you get your lights. Over to the side, same thing over here, except this one's got a fuel tank on this side, and a slightly better little light on the side. Up front, you've got, once again, you've got the cast on the hood and the roof, along with the lights on the roof, or the front of the cab. You've got windshield wipers cast in. And on the bottom, there's drive shaft detail, and that's a little bit of transmission detail, but nothing much after that. And you can see that the tread on the tires is decent. I don't know if you can, it's kind of hard to pick up. It also goes a little bit onto the side, but yes, it's a real, real nice model. I would definitely recommend it if you're a 1/64 scale collector. Can't say I would recommend it for functionality, but for detail, it is amazing, especially for the $8-$9 price. I would have to give it an 8.5 or 9 out of 10. So, you know, if you're looking for a 1/64 scale tow truck or something, this is a real good model. Of course, here you can see with an older 1/64 scale skid steer head lying around, just a nice little detail addition, or for to have a load. The bed does seem a little narrow, especially considering that it does not fit the Ertl F350 dually, though it is a dually. It is a little narrow in my opinion, but it is a very, very nice truck overall. 8.5 or 9 out of 10 is the rating for it. I would give it but that's mostly based on detail. If I was going mainly off of the functionality, I'd probably get more like a 6. But I, you know, it's got so much good detail. I'm going to put an 8.5 or 9. It is just that good of detail for a truck this small, especially for the price of like $8 or $9. You know, it is amazing. So yes, come rate, subscribe. I hope this review will help you if you're looking to buy one of these in any of the color variations, really. So yes, come rate, subscribe.